Welcome to Fashion Sketching for Absolute Beginners. My name is Erica Schmitz and I founded My Body Model to create body positive fashion design tools for people who make clothing for bodies of all shapes and sizes. This course is designed for absolute beginners. This is not a fashion illustration class for people that want to become amazing artists. This class is for people who love to make clothes, who love to sew or knit or crochet, and just want to have sketching as a new tool to add to their toolbox for planning and designing their makes. In just a few short sessions, you'll start to get more comfortable sketching fashion designs on a model of your own body. You'll start to have more fun with the design process and be able to use your sketches to make important design decisions about what you want to make. Step one is to get your fashion templates ready. You can go to mybodymodel.com and create your own fashion design template made to your measurements. We offer a download as a JPEG image file if you like to sketch digitally, or a PDF packet that you can print if you prefer to sketch on paper. For this class, we'll be going with paper. Step two is to gather your art supplies, and you really don't need anything fancy, especially if you're just getting started. All you really need is a pencil and a good eraser, maybe a good pencil sharpener, and a product that's totally optional, but I love it, is a pen made by Pilot. It's called a Frixion pen, and it makes a nice bold black line, but it's totally erasable in case you make any mistakes. Step three is to pull together some inspiration images that you can use as reference and guidelines when you are making your sketches on your body model. I like to use a few different sources of images, and I kind of like to use them in combination to guide me in my sketching. If I'm making a specific pattern, it's really helpful to check out the design flats, which is the technical drawing of the pattern. And this is usually just a simple outline drawing showing the pattern lying flat. And it's a great way to see different design details, like where are the seam lines, where are the darts located. Sometimes in commercial patterns, they're right on the front, sometimes showing with different fabric pairings. And it's a great way to see those really specific details. Another thing to look at is the model photos, which unfortunately in a lot of patterns, the model photos just aren't that helpful to be able to figure out how that garment would look on a body. And for that reason, it's also very helpful to look on Instagram. Looking up on Instagram, really for any pattern, you can look up the hashtag for that pattern, whether it's a sewing, knitting, or crochet pattern, and see real bodies, real people wearing those garments in that pattern. And you can see what those garments are like in the wild and really how they really do land on the body, as well as what they look like in different fabric types. The last place I like to look for inspiration, especially if I don't have a specific pattern in mind, but I'm thinking about a specific silhouette or maybe certain fabric types like linen, which I love, I go to Pinterest. And Pinterest collections are a great place to go for inspiration, especially if you're trying to break out of a style rut and try out different things. You can look at images on Pinterest and then try to sketch them on your own body model. Another great resource on Pinterest is looking up fashion illustrations of specific types of garments. So say you want to sketch a circle skirt or an A-line skirt, you can look that up and find fashion illustration sketches of what those garments look like. And in our Pinterest page, we do have some collections pulled together that you can go through if you're looking to draw a specific type of garment. So when you pull together your images, the next thing to look at is to notice the different design elements. one of the first things to notice is the amount of ease in the design or in the pattern. So is it roomy, or is it super fitted, or somewhere in between? And that gives you a hint as to how to draw it on your body outline, if it's going to be really close to the body outline or giving yourself a little bit of space away from the body. For example, a pattern with a bit of ease, so it's a bit roomy, would be away from the body. So you would leave some space as you sketch around your model. Whereas a pattern that is really fitted to the body, you would draw really close to the outline of the body. Another thing to look at is the type of fabric in the pattern or the design. Or even if it's a knitted or crocheted pattern, thinking about the amount of body or structure versus the amount of drape or flowiness in the fabric. So for example, a kimono pattern typically would use a really drapey, flowy fabric, and the way you're going to draw that on the body is going to be different from how you would draw a pattern that uses fabrics with more body or structure, where they really fall away from the body and would stick straight out. Or if these pants were made using a flowy fabric, they wouldn't be sticking out like that. You would draw them kind of falling closer to the body. So that's another example. Another thing to pay attention to that I mentioned earlier is where the seam lines fall on the garment. And those are details that you want to be sure to draw in your fashion sketch. And that's information that you get from the sewing pattern. Usually the easiest way to look at it is in the design flat, where you can really see where all those seam lines are. Here's another example where you can see the different seam lines. So for example, this one, you can see those seams in the neckline, and that's information that you would use as you make your body model sketch. Another important thing to look at that is maybe an obvious one, but it's helpful to think about, is how long is the hem length? Of course, there's always a lot of flexibility on how long to make your pants or your skirt, or how long to make your sleeves, and that's something that's fun to play around with when you're sketching on your body model and really be able to make those decisions based on how it looks and where you want things to land on your body. And our final step for today, step 5, is draw. Really, the best way to learn about how to do this and to figure out what works for you is just to do it and have fun and experiment, not worry about getting it perfectly right. My number one tip here, especially as an absolute beginner, is to be sure to draw in curved lines, thinking of it as shapes that are going around the body, around the waist, around the arms, around the legs. Those are curved lines going around the body. We'll go into a little bit more detail about specific garment types and how to draw specific elements of different garments in upcoming series. Stay tuned for part 2, which is drawing tops and bodices. I'm really excited to share that with you. For now, if you like this video, please click the thumbs up below and share and follow us on our YouTube channel. Thank you.